Let us talk about the dollar a bit here. Many tell me I'm nuts thinking the dollar will clap. Again, all this is in the Bible, my friend. Everything is in the Bible. You just have to look for it. If you cannot find it, pray. Then look and you will find it. I'm not being smart. It's all in there. China, Russia, and Iran have all authority to crush the dollar, forcing it to crumble. If you do not believe me, hide and watch. Our presidents have had their hands in crushing our dollar and eroding it all. It's all been a plan to exterminate the Americas. Please wake up. China is the biggest holder of foreign exchange capital in the world. If China decided to shift the major portion of its reserve to euro or yen or gold, this would trigger the other bank central banks to do the same. China has been buying up gold. Link is in the box. This would make the dollar worthless if they went the gold standard. The Middle East, Southeast Asia, Africa, Latin America would all jump and dump the dollar and watch the big superpower they despise collapse as they throw a party on our behalf. Once the dollar is in complete free fall, all the oil-producing nations will walk away to the euro. China will emerge as the new superpower, and it's headed there right now. With its money as the new world standard, at all currency taking the place of the once almighty American dollar.
Now on the West Coast, I've been watching the earthquakes on the Ring of Fire line. This is called the Silent War. They hit us with their harp weapon and we hit them with ours. The ones I keep my eyes on are mostly in the West Coast. On any given day, you can watch the Silent War going on Citizens View. Between April the 8th and April the 14th, I watched 90 earthquakes or tremors on the West Coast line, all 3.0 or below, most reported in the and in the area. The only time you will hear about the earthquakes is when they are in the areas that are heavily populated. The Baja California area has been hit many times, as many as 30 times in one day, but only reported twice in the local news or national news. With that said, the last time I checked, there were still tremors going on in this area. I've looked this up, finding the earliest as 1930s, when the prophets began to tell of great earthquakes that will be hitting the California, causing it to fall into the sea, as they called it then. These prophecies, dreams, and visions have not stopped all these years. I tell you, this will happen from the bottom of California to the top of the state of Washington. I've been watching the Silent War of these areas, and it will happen. I did not look up any of this information until after I had my own vision of the war given a word to me from the Lord. The good Lord never said again himself would cause the earthquakes or that they would be man-made in a war, but there is nothing on this earth that he does not allow to happen. Keep that in your hat. He will allow man to destroy himself if it is within his plan. It may look like man did it, but Yahweh is right there all along. Oh, how I love California, driving up and down Highway 101 with the top down. There's just nothing like it. The weather is never too hot. It's never too cold. I love the people, the food. Oh, the food, it is the best. But just like the Jews again, the prophet came to them telling them to leave, and they said, but all my family's here. I love growing the food. It's so beautiful. I just cannot move. I have friends and family in California that just will not leave. They cannot get it in their head. I cannot make them. But I listen to the Lord. He tells me to move. I'm going to move. Where do I live? I'm not going to tell you. The Chinese are very crafty men. They've done all this and have it all planned out, without you knowing it. With all the evilness in this world, in the governments, I am sure they are all in on it as well. Just like when 9/11 happened and all our men were told to stand down. If you have a hard time believing this, just look it up and you will see for yourself. Aircraft in the world. And they could have found the hijackers. But they were told to stand down and let them come upon the soil. I've been shown the military will be told to stand down once again. They will come in great force and kill everyone. They have stated that they will kill all women, children, prisoners, young and old. It will not matter. They will all die. Las Vegas will be bombed and be no more. And it will burn to the ground. Many of our cities in that area will run out of water. And the names of them I have not been shown. But they will become ghost towns. And many will be forced to leave for lack of water to drink. Disease will spread in many towns in the West and thousands will die. As for Yellowstone Park, toxic fumes will grumble out of the volcano, killing birds just before the volcano erupts. As a big warning to us all, I'm about to explode. Many of the wildlife have little by little been traveling out of the park since 2003, sensing the impending danger awaiting for us all in this area.
Whether the volcano is started by man or nature, there will be no way to control it. The sound of this magnitude of an explosion will be heard around the world. What we Americans have sat and watched on our TVs and our YouTube channel will not be compared to when Yellowstone explodes. This will affect many states, killing people, plants, animals, too many to be determined. Yellowstone is called the largest supervolcano in the world. It is not anything to be bragging about when it is in your backyard. The geologists have stated when it erupts, every living thing within a 600-mile radius will die. The force of hundreds of miles an hour ash will cover and choke everything in its course that will sweep downward toward the Mexican border and upward to the Canadian, westward to the Pacific, and eastward to the Mississippi, blocking out all the sun rays for weeks, stopping travel on all roads and major highways. Earthquakes will be setting off down the Pacific coast. The sky will be blocked out with acid rain, with the earth plunging into a nuclear winter. It will eject ash, cutting into your lungs like small glass shards. If you are within its pathway, there will be no hope for you. Survival will only be a few agonizing hours or days as you lay bleeding to death. Your only hope will be to be warned ahead by Yahweh to get out of this area. That's if you're listening. He will tell you a safe place to go before this happens. This will wipe out three states of our food producing areas: Wyoming, Montana, Idaho, and parts of Utah, killing the world's food supply, plummeting it into food deficiency instantly with no way of recovering, with everyone's food supply cut low at this time. Parts of the country will not be able to get to the grocery store. This will cause massive runs on food, cleaning out shelves. Law coming. I see it. They will block off main roads. You will not be able to pass, go into in and out of cities, states, or town. You will need to learn the back roads. Get a motorbike or a bicycle to be able to get around the roadblocks. I see that mail will not be going in and out of the cities as we're used to. I see them enforcing some form of nationwide citizen card. And most of all, health care is not health care. It is to force the mark on all citizens worldwide. This has been their plan all along of the Rothschilds. We were warned by Aaron Russo before he died that this was their plan, and now here it is. It's all about controlling you, controlling the number of the population of the world.